there's all sorts of reasons. I mean, for example, for a certain generation, you know, Jove versus the Volcano, I think, played in a loop on TBS for years. You know, it was sort of hard not to see. But then you come across something like The Super Cops, which Edgar Wright championed. It's this amazing Gordon Parks film. You know, and I think part of the problem was it was a film, and I forget the studio, maybe it's Paramount, but the cops in it are called Batman and Robin. So there's this weird almost like rights issue, you know? So things are lost for all sorts of reasons.
It is fascinating. Now, there was a site on the web. One site on the web had your Guillermo interview in its entirety. I forget which site.
I don't know. We let someone excerpt it. Maybe it was RogerEbert.com.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And it was fascinating. There it is again on the web, and I liked that you could actually read a chapter of your book on the web.
Yeah. We try to get it out there so people will be curious enough to read the rest of the book.
So another site had a movie I really like, which is called City Hall.
Yeah.
John Cusack. And would you consider that a best film you've never seen, or is that in the mainstream enough?
I think that's pretty mainstream. It has Pacino and Danny Aiello, and as you say, Cusack. I think it's got some other heavy hitters in it. But
Fonda, I think. Bridget Fonda, maybe?
Perhaps. But I mean, I don't think it matters who's in it, though. I think, like, for example, I love this film with Donald Sutherland in it and William H. Macy called Panic. And, like, I think myself and maybe Roger Ebert saw it. Like, no one else ever saw it. It's directed by Henry Bramell, who recently just passed away. And he was best known as a director of Homicide. But it is this amazing film about a hitman and his relationship with his father, who is also a hitman, and his young son. So I always recommend that because I think it's a masterpiece that no one has seen.
Now, with all these interviews under your belt and all these people talking about movies, you as a writer, do you get the feeling you want to do a book on your own about your favorite 35 best films people have never seen?
I don't know. I mean, perhaps, but there's also sort of, like, who wants to read that? You know, who is the market for that? I think these directors are far more fascinating than I could be about unseen films. I think the fact that they love them and they bring so much of themselves to the book, I think that is far more interesting than anything I could bring.
Now, after you did the interviews, was there any film that you were turned on to that you really like and that you wouldn't have if you didn't write this book?
Yeah, I mean, there are a couple of them. Peter Bogdanovich turned me on to Trouble in Paradise, which is an Ernst Lubitsch film, and is just a classic, period. It's just an unadulterated classic, and everybody should see it. Sean Durkin, he directed me to a place called a movie called Ten Rillington Place, which is about a serial killer. It's a real story in which Richard Attenborough plays the serial killer. And Sean directed Martha, Marcy May, Marlene. Let me see. There's something else here. And also there's just like weird sort of guilty pleasures. Like, for example, Jonathan Levine, who did 50-50 and Warm Bodies, his choice was Can't Stop the Music, which depending on your depth of film knowledge, it was one of the first films, I think it's tied with Xanadu, to get the Razzie. You know, for the first Razzie, it's the Village People musical.
Mm-hmm.
And it is sort of terrible in all the ways you might think, but also sort of this amazing, you know, document of a time and a place and of a band that is struggling for relevancy. You know, it's 1980 by the time it comes out. Disco is virtually over. The main sort of vocalist has left. In fact, the guy who sings YMCA, he has left